Hey y'all, I'm once again here in beautiful British Columbia, and I just got here last night, and the temperature's a little bit warm, but we're doing our usual late season blacktail hunt, so it should be pretty good. I'm very excited about this. I'm hunting with a bow, although basically the whole time we're here, it's still open for rifle. Yeah, I just want to challenge myself. I came here last year for the bow only season, which starts on December 16th. But this year, we came a little early. I got a buddy coming with me too, 92 Outdoors. He's not here yet, but he's going to be here pretty soon. Yeah, it should be a great time. Last season, almost every single day you went out, you were seeing 10 plus deer sort of thing. I was running into 10 plus deer, and I was just still hunting. And I'm in like a radius of like maybe 5K. So like there's a lot of deer. Yeah, we're on one of the small islands in beautiful British Columbia. Let's hope it goes well. This place is awesome. I love it here. I'm so excited. Right near the ocean. It's super thick in this area, so you gotta like get past this like brush that is like so friggin' thick. And then you're kinda like good. You're in the clear. It's thick at the bottoms, but then once you get up into the bluffs, it's pretty nice. I'm just kind of hoping that it's the same results as last year. I forgot how thick it was in here. Oh my goodness. It's so thick.
I'm just heading back to camp. I just dropped down through those bluffs. I'm gonna have some lunch and then get camp all set up. Just walking up the road, and there was a doe right on the road. So I just got camp all set up. Oh man, look at this view. This is awesome. Yeah, get to wake up, come out. I mean, like, I wake up before light anyways, but it's supposed to be sunny all week. So yeah, it's gonna be so awesome. Yeah, so I brought the wood burning stove, even though I didn't really need to, but I'm on the coast, so there tends to be a lot of moisture here. So if I gotta dry stuff out, I got the wood burning stove, and yeah, it's a nice little setup, you know. There's no point putting up a tarp over me. There's just not gonna be any rain, and even if it does drizzle a little bit, the tent will be dry enough from the wood burning stove. So yeah, we're looking good. I'm just heading into the timber for last light. I'm gonna drop down a bunch of these little bluffs. And then, yeah, kind of just do like a little tiny circle. This morning I did a massive circle. But yeah, I should be able to like drop through, come up, and then drop down through a bunch of these bluffs. Maybe get a glimpse of something. I just heard two shots. All I can say, I got some stiff competition, especially. And then there was those three. smoked today. Freaking put a lot of miles on. Yeah, only saw those three does, surprisingly. I'm gonna head down and then head back to the camp. Just gotta search different areas to find where the deer are kind of, where the majority of the deer are. Interesting fact, I don't know if you noticed, but those bones are very small. That's of a deer. The deer on this island, they are Columbian Blacktail. I thought they were Sitka Blacktail because of how small they were. The species has adapted to a condition called island syndrome. Don't quote exact on me, but basically when the species gets introduced to an island and they stay there for a certain period of time, because it's such a small, it's like a smaller landmass and there's less habitat, the deer become smaller so that their habitat range is technically smaller as well. It's like a form of dwarfism. Look it up. It's pretty interesting. Because these are technically the same species of deer that are on the coast. And they're way bigger on the coast. They're like size of mule deer, some of them, right? So yeah, look it up. It's pretty cool. Maybe someone with an actual biology background that has more knowledge on the deer on the small islands in BC, not on the upper half of BC, but on the bottom half of BC, the islands off the coast. If it is in fact dwarfism, or like island syndrome, that these deer get affected with. Well, I'm just looking at another bone pile. I'll get down there and I'll take a look. But they're tiny. Like, the bones are tiny. Like, these deer are like the size of Frank, my dog. Like, absolutely tiny. It's gnarly in this brush. I'm just working my way up these bluffs and I'm just kind of slowly still hunting. Wind's in my face. Let's hope that we come across a buck and I spot him before he spots me. Popped over this knoll, and I mean, you can't see anything because the brush is so friggin' thick. But, popped over, and deer took off that way, right in the brush, and then another one took off that way. But the one that I saw, like, I got like a tail end glimpse of the one that I saw there, and it looked like substantially like thicker and larger than the rest of the deer that I've been seeing. And like those bucks on the way in those were thick, boys. Like, they were thick. So, I don't really know what my play is here. I'm thinking I'm kind of going to work my way through this back down basically towards where I pushed that deer. And then see what happens. These tiny deer, they're rubbing right in here. Holy gods, it's freaking thick. I'm gonna need a tiny bow for these tiny deer. Maybe one of those little tiny crossbow handguns. Fall zone. Found a little cave underneath a rock. That's pretty cool. Here's the bigger deer of the area. I found him. Well, I found a dead one. He was about to drop his other side. He died in the winter like that. Man, they're small. Like, look at the side of the head. Last year in this exact spot, I saw a 2-point. Like right down on this landing below me. It was a pretty nice 2-point. It's a nice little spot in here.
that's a wrap for tonight. Maybe should have sat till last light, but it's really steep in there, so I wanted to call it pretty quick. I'm gonna hunt tomorrow morning, probably till about noon, and then leave. Last day tomorrow, that's it. Only get 4 hours, and that's all I'm giving myself. Super lame. I literally sat down and the wind switched on me and my sit spot is not a sit spot no more. So I'm back to still hunting. Well, that's a wrap to the 2022 BC hunting season for True Time. Man, it was a good year. I had a lot of fun. First time filming, everything like that. I can't wait till next season. I appreciate all the people who have subbed to the channel. I'm gonna make a lot of videos in the future and, just hopefully gonna get better at this whole filming myself while hunting. I love it out here. It's awesome. Try some new hunts out next year. I'm thinking next year is gonna be a very exploratory hunting year where I just try different zones that I have never tried before. Not my usual spots. If you like the channel and you like the videos, be sure to subscribe. I'm excited for next season.
Yeah, I'm eating sardines. But you know what? It's protein. You know what's even better? Sardines with tomato sauce. If I were you, I'd stick away from that spicy stuff. That hot sauce sardines. Oh, those things are terrible. Anyways, this is brought to you by Loving Sardines.